chance to come and speak to the council. So there's very little opportunity in advance of your one chance to speak to council. So I don't know if you've addressed all of the things, but I thought I would really quickly say some of the things I think are missing in the budget. One of them is MRAP, the Multi-Residential Apartment Building Program, which is our audit program, which goes out in a proactive way, and we try and improve the rental housing stock by actually investigating buildings. We asked for, at the service level review, for the number of buildings to be increased from 200 a year to 250 a year, and what that would cost. They came back with a cost, but it is not recommended. And I can't remember the exact cost. I think it's about 380,000. On, you probably talked about recreation and the things that were in the recreation budget. No. Okay, so in recreation, we had a recreation service plan report last spring in which there were a series of things that were recommended in that report and that council approved, and they are not in the budget. So the things that aren't in the budget are the youth leadership program, the Swim to Survive program, and priority centers, which were to be, are in the budget, but they were to be implemented in the spring if they're not going to be implemented until the fall. 2014. There were other things that were added, council approved, but they did not recommend in the staff budget. Free leisure swimming and equitable programming amongst priority centers or youth drop-in programs, which also came about. There were also recommendations about that activity. So none of those things are in the budget. The other thing is ARC, the After School Recreation and Care Program, which is a program that the city delivers for after school programs. There was a report that came to CDR last month, and they came exactly forward with a recommended expansion of 16 new sites across the city for 500 childcare, or 500 spaces. Council approved it and asked to have it in the budget. It's not in the budget. On childcare, probably, I know Jane is here, probably spoke about it. The analyst notes are wrong. What we approved in the promotion, I moved that we would double the increase in spaces that we put in last year, which was 264 spaces. 528 spaces is what is supposed to have been included in the budget. They are not included in the budget either. Although I'm sure Jane told you, we've just learned we've got an extra $20 million from the province. We're going to have to make sure we press to have that money spent as opposed to putting it into reserves. And that on its face is about the equivalent of 2,000 pre-subsidies. So it's a significant amount of money. We still have a base budget shortfall of $13 million. So what the staff will be pushing to do is to put $13 million in reserve to write off, or into base, to just write off the long-standing cost share and shortfall we've had with the province as opposed to expanding services. So we're going to have to push to do some of both. Both kind of reduce the base budget shortfall and increase the number of food subsidies that we want. And you talked about the Housing Stabilization Fund, FCFA, the Strong Neighborhoods. You talked about Strong Neighborhoods? So FCFA, Strong Neighborhoods. When they came forward, Chris Berlinger's group came forward with a proposal for how we move beyond the 13 priority neighborhoods. I asked for them to come back with a proposed budget asked to go along with the priority neighborhoods work. They came back with it. I think it was about 400,000. I can't remember the numbers off the top. But they came forward with both a capital allocation. As you recall, the 13 priority neighborhoods each got $1 million in capital money over a period of time, but plus operating money. So there was an ask in the council approved it and asked for it to be considered and moved forward to be included in the budget. It was not. That was not included either. And I think that's probably all I can remember at this point. So there's lots of work to do, and I'm glad you're here to figure out He's winning. What I should say, under the service review, service level review, everyone came down and made their pitch around service levels, although it wasn't well publicized. We asked for improvements in service levels. They came back, our staff, and tabled a report last month on what the improved service levels, many of these things I've talked about, would cost. They said it was $70 million. So this is a lot. We're not going to be able to, in the context of a 2.5% increase on the table now, so I don't want to dampen everyone's expectations, but the 0.5% dedicated to Scarborough Subway takes up a lot of tax room. And already the narrative is the tax has been left, are back in control, that the gravy train is pulled out of the station again. And so how much we're going to be able to accomplish in terms of increases and increasing the tax rate is going to be a challenge. So I just want to put that in context. I don't know what $70 million is on the tax rate. It's 0.25% for every $7 million. Well, it's a big jump.
Every percent is $30 million.
So it's another 2%. If we were to get everything, it would be a 4.5% tax increase. And in a pre-election year, I don't think we'll have to vote for that. So on that note,